Hello friends, welcome to the session on transfer of property, that is ownership. In today's session, we will be discussing the rules related to transfer of property, risk factors and also the transfer of ownership by the non-owner. So let's begin. The rules regarding transfer of property or ownership are contained in section 18 to 24 of Sale of Goods Act, which can be classified under three heads. First, transfer of property in specific or uncertain goods. Second, transfer of property in generic or uncertain goods. And the third, transfer of property in goods sent on approval or on sale or written basis. Let's explore these concepts one by one. The first one, transfer of property in specific or uncertain goods. Well, there is a contract for the sale of specific or uncertain goods. The property in them is transferred to the buyer when the parties intend to pass it. It is necessary to fulfill some conditions. The first condition, the contract is for specific goods. Second, the goods are in deliverable state. And third, the goods are not required to be weighed or measured for determining the price. Let us understand it through this example. A sold to B 100 bales of cotton which was kept in his godown. Before the bales could be identified and separated, all the bales got destroyed by the fire. Thus, the seller is liable for damages. Specific goods in deliverable state. Now, in this case, if the goods are not ready in the deliverable state at the time of making the contract of sale, the ownership of goods is transferred after the formation of the contract of sale as per section 20. Thus, there are certain conditions need to be fulfilled. The first, the goods are specific. Second, the goods are in deliverable state. And the third, the contract is an unconditional one, that is, the buyer has knowledge of the facts. Specific goods not in deliverable state. The property in goods that are not in deliverable state will not pass to the buyer unless something is done in order to put them in deliverable state. Let us explore this concept with the help of an example. A certain quantity of oil was purchased by Ajay. The oil was to be filled in the tins. Bharat filled some of the tins and meanwhile informed Ajay to take the delivery. Before Ajay could collect the delivery of the tins, a fire destroyed the entire quantity of oil. Who will bear the losses? In this scenario, Ajay, the buyer, will bear the loss of the oil which was filled in the tins as it was in deliverable state, that is, ready to be delivered. So, the ownership is transferred to the buyer and for the balance oil, the seller must bear the loss. Goods in deliverable state put to be weighed or measured to a certain price. If the goods are not weighed or measured at the time of making a contract of sale, the ownership of the goods is transferred after fulfilling certain conditions. First, the contract is for specific goods. Second, price is not determined at the time of formation of contract but determined later by measurement. Third, goods are put in the deliverable state and the fourth, buyer knows about the facts. Let's see this example. Rakesh purchases a bundle of fodder at rupees 100 per quintal from Damu. However, Damu, the seller, has to weigh the fodder in order to ascertain the price of the entire quantity of fodder sold to Rakesh. The property in goods will pass to Rakesh when Damu has weighed the fodder and a notice thereof is given to Rakesh. Transfer of ownership in uncertain and future goods. The property in uncertain goods or future goods doesn't pass until the goods are ascertained. Well, there is a contract for the sale of uncertain goods. No property in the goods is transferred to the buyer unless and until the goods are ascertained as per provision of section 18. Let's understand this with this example. Mahesh agreed to sell to Seema 5 bags of sugar out of 100 bags of sugar in his godown. The property in goods shall not pass to Seema until the 5 bags of sugar are separated from the bulk and unconditionally appropriated to the contract. Now, assume a situation where in the seller identified 5 bags and informed the buyer, and the buyer agreed to collect the delivery. But before the buyer could take the delivery, the goods were lost. Who shall bear the losses? As goods were ascertained, on ascertainment, ownership was transferred to the buyer, thus he was responsible to bear the losses. Thus, for the transfer of ownership in respect of unascertained goods, two conditions are to be fulfilled. The first, ascertainment of the goods, and the second, their appropriation to the contract. Let's try to understand these concepts. Ascertainment. Ascertainment is the process of identifying and assigning the goods to be delivered. It consists separating, measuring, weighing, counting, etc. in relation to the goods with an intention to identify and determine the specific goods to be delivered under the contract of sale. Appropriation. Appropriation refers to the selection of goods with the exclusive intention of using them in performance of the contract and involves the element of mutual consent of the seller and the buyer. The distinction between ascertainment and appropriation is that ascertainment is a unilateral act and is usually done by the seller alone, whereas appropriation involves common intention or mutual consent. Delivery of goods on approval or on sale or written basis as per section 24. When goods are delivered to the buyer on approval or on sale or written or other similar terms, the property therein passes to the buyer. When he signifies his approval or acceptance to the seller or does any act adopting the transaction. If he doesn't signify his approval or acceptance to the seller but retains the good without giving notice of rejection, then if no time has been fixed for the return of the goods on the expiration of a reasonable time. Let us understand this concept through this example. Raj delivered a horse to Bomen on the terms of sell or return within 8 days. The horse died on the 3rd day from the date of delivery for no fault of Bowman. It was held that Raj, that is a seller, was to bear the loss as the ownership of horse was still with him when it expired. Rules regarding transfer of title on sale. The general rule as to transfer of property is that only the owner of goods can validly transfer the ownership in the goods to the buyer. That is, a non-owner cannot sell the goods and transfer the ownership therein to the buyer even if the buyer has purchased them bona fide and for value. This general rule is expressed by the Roman maxim nemo dat quod non habet, which means that no one can pass a better title than what he himself has. Thus, even a bona fide buyer who buys stolen goods from a thief or from a transferee from such thief can get no valid title to them, for the thief has no title, nor could he give one to any transferee. The general rule as to title aims at protecting the interest of the true owner in particular and is deemed necessary to safeguard the larger interest of society in general. However, this rule is subject to certain exceptions wherein the seller may confer a better title than what he himself possesses. In all, there are 10 exceptions to the rule nemo dat quod non habet. Let's see this one by one. First, sell by a mercantile agent. Second, transfer of title by estoppel. Third, sell by one of the joint owners. Fourth, sell by a person in possession under a voidable contract. Fifth, sell by a seller in possession after sale. Sixth, sell by a buyer in possession after agreement to buy. Seventh, sell by an unpaid seller. Eight, sell by a finder of goods. Ninth, sell by pledgee. And lastly, sell by official assignee or official receiver. Let's see these concepts one by one. The first one, sell by a mercantile agent. Who is a mercantile agent? A mercantile agent means an agent having in the customary course of business as such agent authority either to sell goods or to consign goods for the purpose of sale or to buy goods or to raise money on the security of goods as per the provision of section 2 subsection A. A buyer will get a goods title from a mercantile agent who is in the possession either of the goods or documents of title of goods with the consent of the owner and who sells the goods in the ordinary course of his business provided the buyer buys them in good faith. For example, Amit, the owner of the car, delivered it to Ajit, a mercantile agent, for sale at not less than 2.5 lakhs. Ajit sold the car to Rishi at rupees 1.5 lakhs, who bought it in good faith and without notice of any fraud. Ajit later misappropriated the money. Amit sued to recover the car from Rishi. Will he succeed? The obvious answer is no, as Ajit was in possession of the car with the consent of Amit for the purpose of sale. So, Rishi obtained a good title to the car. Second, transfer of title by estoppel. Estoppel arises when a person by his or her words or conduct makes another person believe that certain state of affairs existed and she or he is later on not allowed to deny that such a state of affairs didn't exist. Applying this rule to a contract of sale of goods, where the true owner of the goods by his act or omission leads an innocent buyer to believe that the seller has the authority to sell, later on he may be estoppel from denying the seller's authority to sell. Example, Rita sells the goods of Bina to Sita in her presence. Bina doesn't raise any objection to it. Here, Sita will get a better title. In this case, if Bina, the real owner, subsequently decides to deny Rita's authority to sell the goods, she may be stopped from doing so and the sale will be binding on Bina. Third, sell by one of the joint owners. If one of several joint owners of goods has the sole possession of them by permission of the co-owners, the property in the goods is transferred to any person who buys them from such joint owners in good faith as per the provision of section 28. Ordinarily, a co-owner can only transfer his or her share, that is, the buyer would obtain only the title of the co-owner. But this section enables a co-owner to sell not only his or her share but also of other co-owners and thereby constitutes an exception to the rule that no one can give what he has not got. Example, A, B and C are joint owners of a car. With the consent of B and C, the car was in the custody of A. A sells the car to P, who purchases it for value. Without notice of the fact that A had no authority to sell, P gets a good title to the goods as he acted bona fide and for value. Sell by a person in possession under a voidable contract. If a person has obtained possession of the goods under a voidable contract and he sells those goods to a bona fide buyer before the contract has been rescinded, the buyer of such goods acquires a good title to them, the provision of section 29. However, for the application of this exception, certain conditions must be satisfied. The seller is in possession of goods under a voidable contract. The goods are sold before the contract has been rescinded, and finally, the buyer buys the goods bona fide and for value. Let's see this example. Akash, by misrepresentation, induces Bharat, a jeweler, to sell and deliver to him a diamond ring. This contract is voidable at the option of Bharat under section 19 or 19A of the Indian Contract Act. But before Bharat could rescind the contract, Akash resells the ring to Samir, who buys it for value in good faith. Thus, without notice of Akash's defective title, Samir acquires a good title. Fifth, sell by a seller in possession after sell. Where a seller, having sold goods, continues to be in possession of the goods or the documents of title to the goods and sells them either himself or through mercantile agent to a person who buys them in good faith and without notice of previous sale, the buyer gets the good title. Let's see this example. Raman sells certain goods to Akshay and promises to deliver the goods the next day. Before delivery, Raman sells and delivers the goods to Sagar, who buys them in good faith and without notice of prior sale to Akshay. Here Sagar will get the good title as he purchased goods in good faith, and remedy available to Akshay is against the Raman, that is the seller, and not against the Sagar. Sixth, sell by a buyer in possession after agreement to buy. If a person who has bought or agreed to buy goods obtains with the seller's consent possession of the goods or of the documents of title to them, any sale by him or her or his or her mercantile agent to second buyer who takes in good faith without notice of any lien or other claim of the original seller against the goods will give good title to second buyer as per the provision of section 30 subsection 2. Example, Anand sells his car for a certain price to Milind on installment basis with a condition that Anand will remain the owner of the car till the last installment is paid. After paying few installments, Milind disposes of the car for an agreed price to Sonia, who bought the same in good faith and without knowledge about any amount due to Anand, the real owner. Sonia acquires a good title to these goods. Seventh, sale by an unpaid seller. As per section 54, subsection 3, where an unpaid seller has exercised his right of lien or stoppage in transit and is in possession of the goods, he may resell them and the second buyer will get a good title to the goods as against the original buyer, even if no notice of the resale has been given to the original buyer. Sell by a finder of the lost goods. Section 169 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 provides that a finder of lost goods has the power to sell the goods under certain circumstances, and the buyer will acquire an absolute title. Accordingly, a finder of goods can sell such goods under certain conditions. The first condition, the real owner cannot be found with search and diligence. Second condition, if found, she or he refuses to reimburse the lawful charges incurred by the finder in respect of the goods found. Third, if the goods are highly perishable or losing the substantial part of its mercantile value, or if the lawful charges of the finder in respect of the thing found amount to 2/3 of its value. Next is sell by a pledgee. On default of the pawner or pledger to repay a loan, or on the failure of the performance of the promise at the stipulated time, the pawnee or pledgee has right to sell the goods pledged with him or her after giving a reasonable notice to the pawner. In such case, the pawnee, even though is not the owner of the goods, can sell the goods and convey a good title to the buyer. Sell by official assignee or official receiver or liquidator. The official assignee or official receiver, liquidator, executors and administrators, although not the owners of a property of goods, can convey better title than they have under certain circumstances. So, friends, in today's session, what we have discussed is about the rules regarding to transfer of property and in which circumstances a non-owner can transfer the title.